One day there was a father and his son who's only 4 years old walking down the street. If I remember how the story's told, the father saw a stranger in traffic and he yelled, but he had headphones on mumbling like he's rapping to himself. And he must have just never even heard him or just doesn't care, but it seemed like he just sort of ignored him like he wasn't there. And as the plot unfolds, the truck driver in a diesel on his cell phone speeding didn't watch the road. You ever seen a wide receiver when he goes open, the quarterback throws the ball like everything's in slow motion? Yeah, well this is sorta like one of those moments. But the crowd is not excited, they stone frozen. And as the tires screech, the father has to make a decision for a perfect stranger that's in dire need. In a split second he jets over and runs. In compassion for a stranger he lets go of his son. Now what happens in the next few seconds kinda hurts to tell, beyond anything that letters mixed inside of words could spell. He grabs him out the way, but when they fell they shook the floor. The stranger gets up and yells,
"Man, what the hell you pushed me for?"
The father's voice was like thunder if you heard the sound as he cries out,
"Turn around!
What?
Turn around!"
The stranger looks in horror and disbelief as he sees the four-year-old boy laying in the street. He opened up his mouth and tried to scream, but nothing happened. He tried to get his feet to run, but there was no reaction. The truck driver must have swerved, but it doesn't matter, it's too late. The body's on the floor with the blood splattered. Stranger trembles as it grips him full of fear, looks at the father and sees his face dripping full of tears. He tries to ask him why, but his throat just wouldn't clear. "Because I love you," the father slowly whispers in his ear. "Father in heaven, I bought you this present. It was raining for a little bit, I thought it would let up, but it didn't. So I got up and went out to the mall, went shopping, look, I bought you this sweater. I spent my whole paycheck on it, and I've been dying just to see you wear it. Kind of embarrassed, I stood there crying with these people staring, but they ain't get it. The pressure of this very moment, what I was holding was more than fabric or some sweater folded. This was everything, all that I could afford to buy you, hope you like it." They said every purchase in the store is final, but hey, you know they say that it's the thought that matters. Dang it, now I'm starting to think I probably should have got you the camera. This guy's in front of me, I'm supposed to be the first in line. I read his t-shirt, said John 3:16, Church of Zion. That's when I realized that none of this is worth my time, 'cause I'm trying to buy your love when you purchase mine. Dang.